we're gonna do some ionic bonding, and we're gonna do some nomenclature with it. Just so you know, this video is going out to you, Paul Wahlberg, for opening a Wahlburgers today, no less, on October 28th, 2019, in Frisco at the Star. One of my favorite restaurants to go to. Okay, anyways, ionic bonding. We're talking about losers and winners. Metals are total losers of electrons, and non-metals are the winner. Remember, when you're looking for ionic compounds, these have a metal and a non-metal, or you're going to see them start off with NH4+ and a non-metal. And sometimes the non-metals are really polyatomic ions. Hopefully you have all of those memorized. I know Paul Wahlberger does, right? Right. We need some sound for this.
It's you and me, Megatron.
It is. And that's what we need for those polyatomic ions. We need to know them. Okay, so one of the most important concepts to understand is naming and writing ionic compounds. So we're going to go over these charges. Hopefully you remember what these charges were. So group 1 is plus 1. Group 2 is plus 2, or 2 plus as I'm writing. Group 3 metals are plus 3. Okay. Notice that the ones that are losing electrons are positive. Non-metals, if it gains 4 electrons, it is minus 4, or 4 minus. Okay, now we get to some of the tricky ones here. Metals that lose 2 or 4 electrons that are in group 4. Because group 14, or as I like to call it, 4A, remember? This is 4A, this is 3A, this is 2A, this is 1A, 5A, 6A, and 7A. Right? 4A. There are metals that have options. There are going to be 2 plus or 4 plus, depending on what they are bonded to. Which metals are these? These are most likely SN or PB. Tin or lead. It has options for its charges. Plus 2 or plus 4. Okay. Non-metals that gain 3 electrons, minus 3. And these are the typical charges. Then we get to 5A metals. Yes, there are metals in 5A too. If it loses 3 or 5 electrons, is it going to be plus 3 or 5 plus? The most infamous metal for this is bismuth. Bi. Non-metals that gain 2 electrons is 2 minus. Non-metals that gain 1 electron is 1 minus, based off the group numbers. Group 7A, 6A. Okay, then, it gets even more fun. There are elements that only have one set of charge as well. Okay, these are members of the silver staircase, which I will show you later, where the silver staircase is. You need to memorize these as well. Ag is plus 1. Zinc is plus 2 only. And cadmium is plus 2 only. There is no multiple charges for these. The other element metals in the middle will have multiple charges. And we will go over how to figure all that wonderful stuff out. Right? But
be short.
Try that again, Mr. Herodom.
Time is short. Be short.
Time is short. Okay, now, ionic compounds. Binary ionic compounds. These have 2 elements. Okay. Doesn't mean 2 atoms total, just 2 elements. Okay. All compounds have a charge of 0. Okay. Have to make the charges cancel out. Okay? That is the goal. Okay? primary compounds end in IDE. Okay? If they end in something else besides IDE, like ATE or ITE, those are polyatomic ions, which some of them you have to memorize and some of them you don't. Okay, so here we go. Lithium fluoride. Lithium is Li, 1+. Fluoride is F-. So we have +1 and -1. Does that equal 0? By Jove, it does. So this is LiF. Okay? And I really should have done it like this, because that's how I really do it. And make sure that they cancel out. Magnesium. Magnesium is in group 2. So we know magnesium is 2+. Phosphide is in group 5. We know that phosphorus is 3-. So we have an Mg2+, and we have a P-3. That does not equal 0. So then I add another Mg2+. That doesn't equal 0. Then I add another P-3. That doesn't equal 0. Then I add another Mg2+. So now I have 3 Mg2+s and 2 P-3. So my correct formula, and the only possible formula, by the way, for magnesium phosphide, is Mg3P2. Zinc. Zinc was one of those that we have to have memorized. Zinc is +2. It is part of the silver staircase. And then iodine is a halogen. It is I-1. So this is ZnI+2-1. So we need another -1. That equals 0. So this is ZnI2. Okay? Okay, brief intermission to tell you how I get these charges, remember. Group 1, +1. Group 2. +2. Group 3, +3. Group 4A, +/-4, typically. -3, -2, and -1, and 0. Okay? That's a start. Then you also have the silver staircase. Silver is Ag. It is +1, right there, always. Cadmium is +2, and cadmium, that's not cadmium, Mr. Heridum, that is zinc. Zinc is also +2. Because remember, back in the day, I called this group 1B. I called it 1B because I knew silver was +1. And I called this group 2B because I knew silver and cadmium were +2. Okay? Aluminum is always +3. Gallium is always +3. And indium is always +3. Those charges never change. Then there is another smaller staircase to the right here. We can see this. There is tin right there. Tin is +4 or +2. Lead is right below it. It is +2 or +4. So would this element be whatever it is?
Should I see what it is just for fun?
Fl. Sure. I'm not going to ask you any Fl questions, but +2 or +4. Bismuth is right here. Would be +3 or +5. And the one below bismuth would be also be that, which I would never ask you about. Mc, +3 or +5. That is my official periodic table formula chart thing that I use to figure out the charges. The ones between here, let's get a good color here. From here, over to here, to over to here, to over to here. These have multiple charges. The ones down here, guess what? They have multiple charges. And you have to back calculate these out to figure out what these charges are. Okay? Don't worry. Paul Wahlberg approves of that. Okay. After that little interlude there, that was wonderful and great, Mr. Heridum. Here we go. You're back with gallium. Gallium is Ga, because I know all my students have all their elements memorized, which is plus 3 because it's in group 3. Bromide is over here in the halogens. Bromine is over here somewhere. That is minus 1. So we have a Ga 3 plus, and we have a Br minus 1, Br minus 1, Br minus 1. So this is Ga Br 3. Because remember, the goal was to get the charges to equal 0. Potassium sulfide, again, this ends in I. So we know it's just an element. Potassium is K, K plus. Sulfide is S. 2 minus. So we have a K plus and an S 2 minus. Does that equal 0? No. We need another K plus. So this is K2S. Okay. Then we do silver bromide. Silver. Silver is Ag. It's part of the silver staircase. That one is always plus 1. Bromide is Br. Minus 1. Ag plus and Br minus, does that equal 0? Ag, Br. That is our correct formula. It's very important that we know how to write formulas. Okay? Also, always remember, one of Mr. Irvin's favorite sayings, you have to be positive, then negative. That's how compounds work. Alright? Because the cations are positive, and the anions are always negative. Okay? So that's why you always name the metal first when we're naming these compounds, then the non-metal. Okay, I'll do these two examples really quick, and then I'll make another video for the next one here. Okay, we're talking about binary compounds still. Now we're going from names here. So we have CaCl2, okay? We know Ca is calcium. We know Cl is chlorine. Notice that we change the ending to -ide, okay? Because it is binary. Binaries always end in -ide. So this is Al, this is O, aluminum oxide, okay? No need for the number of atoms for ionic, okay? I didn't call it dialuminum trioxide. That's what you would do if it was covalent, if there was two non-metals. This one is ionic, so it's based off of charges, so you just name it. So for instance, Na. Hopefully you know Na is sodium. O is oxygen. Since it's a binary compound, we've changed the ending to IDE, so this is O sodium oxide. Okay. Ba is barium. I is iodide. We need another sound effect really quick, don't we? Before we end this video. Let's see what this says.
Permission granted.
Okay, that's great.
I am Optimus Prime.
That's great. So this is iodide. So this is iodide. Okay. Guys are champions. Just like Paul Wahlberg. Legend.